Calling out false teachers is not fun, but it is necessary. Jesus loves the church, and the church is called to protect sheep by preaching the truth and calling out error. Romans 16, verses 17 and 18 says, "Now I urge you, brothers and sisters, to keep your eye on those who cause dissensions and hindrances contrary to the teaching which you learned, and turn away from them, for they are slaves of not the Lord Jesus Christ, but their own appetites. And by their smooth and flattering speech, they deceive the hearts of the unsuspecting." False teachers are looking for people who fall for flattery and who do not know their Bibles. Biblical literacy and discernment should matter to all of us if we love Christ and people. Now, not all false teachers are intentionally deceiving people, but some are. 2 Timothy 3:13 says that in the last days, evil men and imposters will go from bad to worse, deceiving and being deceived. But just because some are deceived themselves doesn't mean we should ever hold back from warning you about their dangerous ministry. So to help do our part, hear it for the gospel, we're going to proclaim the truth like we have been and start adding in videos like this one that lovingly warn you about a specific false teacher. The first one up, Michael Todd. Michael Todd has become one of our generation's most popular preachers because he's funny, he's a great communicator, and he preaches to felt needs. He's a master entertainer who has the persona of a celebrity athlete, only he's the pastor of Transformation Church in Tulsa, Oklahoma, which is a Word of Faith region and a hub known for its heritage of false teachers. One particular false teacher who is widely known and embraced in that region is Kenneth Hagin. He was one of the original prosperity gospel pioneers. And if you're not familiar with the likes of Kenneth Hagin, this is him making people drunk in the so-called spirit back in the day. Okay, that's enough of that. On to Michael Todd. In a modern day and much more polished approach, Word of Faith teachers like Michael Todd are a mixture of Joel Osteen one-liners.
God is not limited by what you're facing. He's limited by what you're believing.
And Stephen Furtick's flair.
I'm not in covenant with a political party. I'm in covenant with God Almighty. I am God Almighty.
They get the crowds roaring by preaching the prosperity gospel, which is that it's always God's will for you, if you'll just believe in Jesus Christ, to be happy, healthy, and wealthy in all areas of your life. The church's doctrinal statement actually says, under the heading, Health and Prosperity, we believe that as part of Christ's work of salvation, it is the Father's will for believers to become whole, healthy, and successful in all areas of life. Spiritual, mental and emotional, physical, and financial. That's all you need to mark and avoid Michael Todd as a prosperity gospel preacher, because the prosperity gospel is not a minor secondary issue. I've written a book called God, Greed, and the Prosperity Gospel, and it takes down every single error they teach while propping up God's glorious truth. And if you need some more help on the prosperity gospel, you can watch the documentary American Gospel to learn all about why false teachers who preach the prosperity gospel should be avoided at all cost. Michael Todd's influence is dangerous, and because of his egregious antics in the pulpit, many people are being led astray. One recent example is when he butchered the meaning of John chapter 9 and Jesus' healing of the blind man to mean that when God gives you a vision, things are going to get messy, referring to how Jesus spat in mud and rubbed it on the man's eyes when healing his blindness. The whole message is a disgusting failure to preach God's word accurately and faithfully. But the illustration you're about to watch is not for those with a weak stomach, so if you haven't seen it already, be prepared and feel free to just get to the point and then fast forward past this.
Jesus said, "You good, brother?" Now watch. He can't see, but he can hear. And this is the moment where many of us are in, is that God is doing something and we hear him changing. We hear him even in your prayer. And in this time, he's changing something and you don't see it clearly yet. But you hear. And this is where most people would not face Jesus anymore. What most people would do is turn away. What I'm telling you is just as he's physically standing here, knowing what's coming, God's saying, can you physically and spiritually and emotionally be able to stand when getting the vision or receiving it might get nasty? I'm gonna say it in a point just like that. Receiving vision from God might get nasty. You mean, God, I just bought, in crazy faith, I just bought my dream car. And now you're gonna ask me to sell it back and ride in the hoopty again? Yeah, because the vision I'm about to give you, it might get nasty. And do you hear and see the responses of the people?
I don't use the word disgusting lightly, but that is both physically and spiritually disgusting. Friend, you do not need Michael Todd's messages for any purpose except to showcase what happens when men are lovers of self, filled with greed, and pandering in the pulpit for the roaring crowds to be entertained. Men like this are building something, but it is not God's kingdom. Mark and avoid Michael Todd. Don't have him at your conferences, don't go to conferences where he preaches, and most certainly stay away from his church. That is not a church. He is not a pastor. He is a false teacher. We pray that the Lord would change his heart and many of the people following him. As for you and I, let's study sound doctrine. Let's keep our eyes on Jesus, and let's keep our hearts soft that we might still pray and hope that lost sheep would come home.